Good evening. I hope everyone is well. I have completed the inner circle cards for the present, and I have gotten to the fourth position in the future. The center wheel or future wheel. Let's see, I'm not I can do that and straighten it out. That's gonna drive me bonkers. I'm gonna straighten up this thing so it's not so finicky. Okay, so card 18, hopes, desires, and pleasures for the future, 6 of Wands. Victory. 6 of Wands. I can't make up my mind. 6 Wands. Victory. Because of planning. Thank you. health and concerns. No. Knight of Swords. Escape plan. Swords and Knight of Swords. Knight of Swords. The escape plan. While nature, humanity, and our sanity is fleeting, we learn to be warriors. Regulating passion is not the knight's Regulating passion is not the knight's strong suit, as it requires being grounded in their skin. For years, they swore love, fucking, and companionship were the body's greatest medicine. The only thing that will truly ground them in order to fight this war. However, dreams get crushed and paths get reconstructed. Priorities beg for change. The knight's body knows and continues to search for other medicine, other ways to feel whole, other ways to enable passion and the motivation to fuck shit up. The Knight of Swords can carry their rage in uncharted space. They can hold their own heart. The Knight of Swords is eager to set a revolution into high gear. They understand the animal instinct to rage and wreak havoc on community when you're invalidated since birth. Gender, race, class abilities, and trauma clash with the traditional values we are fed. The Knight of Swords is the warrior unleashed after we self-destruct. They ask you to navigate your rage, stop at the silent crossroads that have paved your wildest highways, and pause. Breathe if that rage causes you cause harm. Smile if that rage reminds you that the world's injustices are abominations.
The Knight of Swords is a brown, queer, non-binary creator witch of the East and West, wild with ambition and tired from experience, but weaving El Machete al Silencio. They ask you to be accountable to your mistakes and to the people you've burned. They ask you to squash the pressure, to forgive the people who burned you until you decide you are ready. Accept the challenge of life and find the kind of rage that is transformative. Stabbing us. Partners, loved ones, Four of Swords, Respite. first bell, Four of Swords. Sometimes it's just better if I read the book. Whoops, too many pages back. Your brain, the news, the questionable behaviors of those we wish didn't affect us, the questionable fees for every technological advancement, the uncomfortable silence that follows every truth, just a few reasons to retreat in the name of self-preservation. The Four of Swords is a testament to your needs, discomforts, and gut wrenches. Whether or not past trauma is influencing current reactions, they are real reactions to real circumstances, real disrespect you are trying to articulate, real feelings of enthusiasm that are too close to the edge of chaos. Sure, you can attack yourself for negotiating with your higher self, and then what? Your higher self wins the debate because you had a good day? So it's easy to put your issues on the shelf where they never truly heal. Now is the time to reflect on the shit-riddled minefields that ruined your week and find yourself smiling on the beaten path. Your higher self will be waiting. After the storm, the earth recuperates, as does the Four of Swords. After debilitating circumstances, we are exhausted. Excuse me. Yet we are eager to push beyond the superhuman capability of merely human. We choose vices, crutches, and paths to survival that may destroy us. The Four of Swords eventually found his sanctuary, a cluttered workspace where his favorite tools frame his chaos. He asks you to find peace in your search for stability. How do you recharge the heart after it has long suffered? How do you separate your healing from the healing of the outside world while staying aware? The Four of Swords reminds us to recuperate in times of burnout, post-traumatic stress, flares of chronic pain, and the undercurrents of survival that challenge our power. Now is the time to find power in isolation. The Four of Swords asks you to learn growth, learn accountability, learn self-care. We're no good to others. The mystic symbol for the future portrays potential gains. Reevaluating the Four of Cups. Don't forget to always potentials. Copy that down. And let's call that good for tonight. There's my cryptic, sparse, whatever. Tonight, that's pretty good. Stay safe, everybody. Peace. Love you all. Toodles.